Hello, welcome back to Scaffold Design for Scaffolders. I'm Alejandro Garcia and today I will solve the three exercises I gave you at the end of lesson 9. Cantilevers. So, let's go with the first one. We have a cantilever with a 3 km per meter line load. As usual, we want to solve first the reactions and then the bending moment. So we will use two equations of statics, summation of vertical loads equals zero and the summation of moments on A equals zero. Reactions. We have RA and we also have RB. And those two together must be equal to the total line load. So 3 km per meter times 5 meters, that is 15 kilonewton. Now if we take moments on A, we have RP times 4 meters, and then on the opposite direction we have the line load, so it's going to be 3 km per meter. The total load is 3 times 5, and then just the arm from the center of the line load. So that's going to be 2.5 meters. And that must equal 0. Therefore, we get that RB equals 9.4 kilonewtons. And if RB is 9.4, then we can solve that RA equals 15 minus 9.4. So they're going to be 5.6 km. Now we have the reactions, we can calculate the moment diagram. So to calculate the moments, we already know the reactions. So let's calculate from 0 to 4 meters, I mean from one support to the other, and then from the support P to the end of the cantilever. From 0 to 4, we have going from left to right the reaction, so 5.6 times x. And now we subtract the line load. So it's going to be 3 kilonewton per meter times x to get the load. And now the arm is going to be x divided by 2. And that's going to be valid up to support B. If we continue, then we will have, as before, 5.6x minus 3x squared divided by 2. But now we add reaction B positive and is 9.4 times x minus 4 meters. Now if you apply different values to x, like 0, 1, 2, whatever you want, you will be able to draw the moment diagram. Here I'm just going to calculate two different values. M equals 2 meters is not the highest bending moment between A and B, but it's very close. So for x equals 2 meters, we have that moment equals 5.6 times 2, and we subtract 3 times 2 meter squared divided by 2. And that's 5.25 kilonewton per meter. Now you will see that the real value of the maximum moment in that area is going to be 5.27. So I mean, it's close enough to 2 meters. And for 4 meters, we have 5.6 times 4 meters minus 3 times 4 meters squared divided by 2. And here we get minus 1.5 kilonewton per meter. Why do they have different signs? Because first we have, well, the bending is going to be in opposite directions. Let me show you the moment diagram. See, here we have the exact values, I mean, with 2 decimal for all reactions. So here we have the moment we calculated before. If you remember, for M2, we say this 5.25, and then this is equal to M of X equal 4. So what happens is the left hand side is behaving more like a bridge, and then at the end we have this small cantilever that is bending on the opposite direction. Now let's go to exercise 2. In this case we have another cantilever but with many point loads and no line load. As before, let's calculate the reactions with the static equations. And here we have that Ra plus Rb must equal 6 kN times 3 plus 12 kN plus 10 kN. And that's a total of 40 kN. Now, if we take moments on A, we have, I will start with reaction on B. This is positive times 5, and all the others go with negative. So we have minus 6. Times 2, minus 6 times 4, minus 6, sorry, 6 times 4. No, now we have minus 12 times 6, and now minus 10 times 7 meters, and that must equal 0. So if we solve this, we get that Rb equals 35.6 and therefore Ra is going to be the difference between 40 minus 35.6. So that's going to be 4.4 kilometers. Now we can calculate the moment diagram. We already know the reactions. Now we can calculate the moment along the beam. As before, I will just divide it from A to B and then from B to the cantilever. Starting from left hand side, we have the reaction, (4.4x) minus 6x minus 6 times x minus 2 minus 6 times x minus 4, and now that's it. If we continue going as before from left to right, we will have as above 4.4x minus 6x minus 6 times x minus 2 minus 6 times x minus 4. Now what we add? We add reaction on B that is going to be positive 35.6 times x minus 5. And now we subtract the Schwarzkopf polynomial. So it's going to be minus 12 times x minus 6. We don't consider the 10 km polynomial because it's at the end, so the distance to the end is going to be 0. Now, if we calculate the moment on support B, we get 4.4 times 5 meters, minus 6 times 5, minus 6 times 3, and minus 6 times 1. And that's a total of 32 kilonewton meter. Now, as before, if you want to get the complete moment diagram, we just apply different values for x, and you get this diagram. As you see now, we have the whole moment diagram negative, because the biggest loads in this example are on the cantilever. Let's solve now exercise 3. Now we have a line load with 0.2 kN per meter self weight and two point loads, 9 km and 8 km on the cantilever end. We are going to calculate two reactions using two static equations. Summation of vertical loads equals 0 and summation of moments on A equals 0. So we know that at A plus RB must equal 0.2 kN per meter times 8 meters plus 9 km plus 8 km for a total of 18.6 kN. Now, taking moments on A, we have that RB times 6 meters minus 0.2 kN per meter times 8 meters times 4 meters and minus 9 km times 7 meters and minus 8 km times 8 meters equal 0. If we move values to one side to leave RB alone, we get that RB equals 22.2 kN. And therefore, RA is going to be 18.6 minus 22.2. So, minus 3.6 kN. Why is it negative? Well, first, it means that the arrow I'm showing for RA, that red arrow, is on the wrong direction. So there is uplift on support A. Now let's calculate the moment diagram. So this is the moment diagram. As you see, because we only have point loads on the cantilever span, all the moment is negative, And as remember, as we said before, that we have an uplift here, minus 3.6, or roughly 360 kilograms. So what will happen if we don't put a cantilever or anchor to the slab, or prop against the higher to the ceiling, against the ceiling slab? But the beam will go up, and the scaffold or whatever is on the span will collapse. We will explain it again in the future. Just remember that as a minimum, we apply a factor of safety of 1.5 for overturning on a cantilever. So whatever uplift you will calculate, at least you will increase it 50% to calculate the cantilever unit. Obviously, this will depend on the standards you apply, but 50% is usually a minimum. Well, thank you for watching. This being all for today. If you didn't get your correct answers, please try again. And any issues, please leave me a comment with questions, and I will answer as soon as I can. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.